most people in life are looking for how do I make a life worth living and retirement with having. When I begin every audiocast with the same sort of simple mantra, I'm trying to remind people of where their boundaries in life begin and end. We have a lot of people in the retail establishments that are learning technological skills in either their downtime at work or their off time out of work. The challenge is they like to use their public Wi-Fi in the companies in which they serve, those national organizations of which they're employed, and they like to interfere with consumers who either walk near or go near their networks. Most of us know that our phones can be set up to automatically grab Wi-Fis that we're near to save on our cell minutes, if you will, or to simply to cut costs. Because free Wi-Fi is something that most organizations across America that are considered with it in terms of technology offer to their constituents, offer to the guests of their stores, offer to their consumers and their purchasers of their vended products. It's sort of an interesting conjugation or juxtaposition to think about how many hourly employees try to behave as if they are the president of their company, who probably is several states away in a corporate office. The hourly employee wants to feel power, wants to feel intrigue, wants to feel something other than the hourly aspect of literally standing around, stocking shelves, repairing things in fall, if you will, or literally just straightening things so that everything looks pretty well overall. But in life, their job is to do what? To keep customers. To make and keep customers. Whether the consumer buys today or whether the consumer buys tomorrow, it really doesn't matter to the company. At least a good company president would think so. Of course, he or she would prefer that the consumer going in and out of their store or going near their store would buy from them almost every day. If it's a restaurant, you have the potential of earning that kind of business, especially if your business or your food that's vended is a reasonable price, say $10 to $12, there is a potential that you could have a consumer that sees you almost every single day and you should treat them as an A client. Obviously, there are B clients that maybe come a couple times a week and C clients that don't quite come that often. You'll start to recognize the faces of the people that come regularly. But the reality is we cannot have hourly employees pretending as if they are in charge of someone's technology. I have an interesting story from earlier in the week that I'd finally received a stipend from an organization so that I could make some purchases at an office supply store. I've been sort of perusing their website a little bit here and there at different places that I would go and when I was around their store. And I was making kind of a list of things that I need to buy for my business venture and more. Unfortunately, that manager, that supervisor, that hourly employee didn't quite understand that an elderly person who has narcolepsy or an elderly person that is a walking impediment or an elderly person who wants to get out of the heat of a summer's day has absolute right to find a regular space on a public sidewalk to sit, to work, and to literally converse on the telephone. Unfortunate for that company is the proof that we are acquiring that someone in their organization has not only been thieving intellectual property, they've actually been probably selling that property to other people. The only way, of course, an organization like that can evaluate that would be go through and look at their actual internal network systems that shows what is being produced by their employees and print it off for alleged consumers and literally the videotapes that watch them do that on a regular basis. These are things we cover in risk management classes, in consumer rights training, in how to get and keep customers orientations. Many companies around the community today are desperate for the hourly employee, but our challenge is that we're not raising our children to value hourly work. Hourly work is best served by high school students, college students, and people who didn't quite go on much further in their thinking of what they want in life. It is the right kind of work for certain people and the wrong kind of work for other types of people. But when you have the right and the opportunity to make a customer for life, it's always better to choose to make a customer for life than choose to harm a customer for life.